Hello and welcome back. You're watching Aprilia Futura ABS retrofit. In previous episodes, this coolant pipe wouldn't last long on this pot, so I reinforced it with a 3D printed pipe. I think I did quite a decent job, but time will tell. Then I tried to bleed the rear brake. Dear Lord, pumping, pumping, pumping. I've tried many different tricks, nothing worked, nothing, literally nothing, so I gave up, at least for now. Meanwhile, look what I found. Wire harness took a lot of time to make. Quite a lot of measuring, cutting, soldering and testing. I don't want my videos to look like that, so I skip most of that. Soldering is very interesting topic, but watching someone on YouTube do that, not so much I guess. Here's how most of this job looked like. I had to check ABS sensor polarity, as this is not a very well documented part of any wiring diagram. To do that, I hooked ABS unit to an old battery. I can get a nice square signal, so it's okay. Every exposed joint or connector has to be protected against moisture. In this case, I used a hot glue gun. Funny thing is that every single Futura has an ABS light inside the cluster, but none of them actually has an ABS. All I had to do is find the wire, cut it and solder a new wire. Copper-knot wiring diagrams helped me a lot. They have literally the same cluster hardware, and they have an optional ABS. The light is off when the wire is grounded. With so many wires, this whole system became a mess, so I shortened some of them and tidied them up. That's better. What I didn't realize is that the stop screw of the rear brake lever was in a completely wrong position, which means that the piston of a master cylinder didn't have enough travel to bleed successfully. Not knowing that, I blamed long brake lines and possible air gaps, siphons and places the air bubbles could hide to. So I replaced all brake lines and used copper lines instead. At least I don't have to worry about heat resistance near the exhaust. A year ago I had a brake line failure due to overheating on this spot, and have been left without rear brake when on a 2-day trip. See that short travel? That just couldn't work. After I readjusted the lever stop screw, weaving was an easy task. So the cabling is basically done. Here I have a cable for diagnostic socket, and this is a cable for an ABS button. It's all tied up a bit with cable ties, but I managed to do some mistakes with wiring. Some of the tape had to be removed and some wires rewired. Not to get too much into details, I put things into their places. And with rear brake equipped with an ABS, it was time to give it a try. Yes, it was actually a full power braking, and it was actually my first ride with an ABS equipped bike, so I didn't know exactly what to expect. Oh, here goes the empty battery again, and obviously a single use drill. And not only that, I managed to damage a thread a bit, that will have to be cleaned up. But with ABS working impressively on the rear, I couldn't wait to drive on the front brake. So here is the mess of a Futura's anti-lock braking system waiting to get on the road for the very first time. Let's go! It works beautifully. Locks, releases, brakes again. Locks, releases, brakes again. It looks like it works very slowly, and it does on the very slippery surface. Oh, and I found out that the ABS off switch is not a switch, it's a button. Hold it until a light flashes 3 times, release it, and the light keeps flashing and the ABS is off. The system is re-engaged by cycling ignition. Reassembly showed that the fairing parts are quite a bit under strain, because the ABS unit is not that small and there is actually not a lot of space under the shell. With some additional trimming, I managed to get things together somehow. Yes, they're still under some strain, but lines on the left and on the right are not so different, considering that the tank is also under some tension because of the rear brake line on the left. These things will have to be taken care of. But they're good enough for a first real road test with a complete bike. Let's take a look. And with half speed. The story is far from over. See you next time.